Blackstone presents The Worm in Every Heart, Stories by Gemma Files. This book is read by Gabrielle de Cuir, Natasha Soudek, Deepti Gupta, Joanna Perrin, Jean Brassard, Nancy Wu, Rasha Zamamiri, Carlotta Brentan, Alana Kerr Collins, Stefan Rudnicki, Anne Flosnik, Heath Miller, Helen Lloyd, Emily Lawrence, Joel Froomkin, Paul Woodson, and Tim Lounibos. Introduction by Nancy Kilpatrick. Read by Gabrielle de Cuir. I first met Gemma Files in Toronto in the early 1990s. I'd been a fanatical purchaser of vampire books and had a vast collection of titles, which now exceeds 1,700, God help me. Vampire volumes had come into vogue by then, and since I'd managed to acquire just about everything written prior to that time, I was relegated to the fresh blood of newly published works. Every month, I would watch the cash register tally up four or more hardcover titles, depleting my finances and overburdening my bookshelves. I frequently purchased from Baca Books, which at that time was Toronto's only SFFH bookstore. John Rose, the owner, kept saying, "You must know Gemma. She's the other vampire collector." So I'd heard about Gemma, but we never seemed to be browsing in Baca on the same day of the night of the full moon. I'd also been informed by a discerning bookish pal, Bob Haji Knowlton, about his friend Gemma. "You've got to meet this girl. She's brilliant and she loves vampires." I didn't put the two Gemmas together until the day I received a call. Gemma and I chatted a while, and I invited her to visit and see my book collection and all the other vampire memorabilia, read junk, I'd acquired over the years, like a piece of plaster from the Grand Theatre in Derby, where Dracula was first staged, a promotional keyring from Dracula's wallpaper warehouse in Ontario, the four-foot-tall Nosferatu punching bag. Right from the get-go, I knew Gemma was, as Bob said, brilliant. This young thing was just wiggling out of journalism school. She was the precocious offspring of parents in the arts, which likely set her up for being highly educated, thoughtful, attracted to all things creative, a bit melancholy, and extremely well-read in the wide world of books, not just those involving bloodsuckers and other demons of the night. She arrived at my door wearing her multicolored Moroccan cap, serious but modern glasses, and carrying a huge backpack, which she always seemed to be lugging around. We talked vampires for hours. Needless to say, I liked her immensely. Not only was it refreshing to chat with another vampirophile, but I found her open and honest, and not fearful about plunging into free-rolling discussions involving the deeply existential and macabre subject matter I favor. I became a kind of loaning library for books she hadn't yet read, and a minor sounding board for projects, of which she had plenty in mind. So we met regularly for a while, until life impinged. For me, that meant the ending of a marriage and a move to Montreal. At the time I met Gemma, she had been writing regular columns, mainly on film, for one of Toronto's entertainment weeklies, I Magazine. Besides reading her published articles, she handed me bits of her fiction to peruse, and I always came away thinking the same thing about her work. Brilliant. Clearly, this girl was destined for great things. So it surprised me not when she catapulted out of the small press and began selling her short stories to major anthologies, like the cleverly conceived Stephen Jones-edited The Mammoth Book of Vampire Stories by Women, and Dark Terrors 6. Ellen Datlow picked up her amazing tale, The Emperor's Old Bones, originally published in Northern Frights 5, and which is included in this collection, for Year's Best Horror and Fantasy 13. Gemma also sold stories to television and won the International Horror Critics Award. If I'd put money where my thoughts were about Gemma's fate, I'd be rich now. But then, who would have bet against me? Gemma utilizes style and grace in her writing and possesses an adventurous spirit that shows.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.